Okay, time for round three. We lost the die roll the third time in a row and have to mulligan again. This is a decent keep with a solid scry on top. Let's see how this goes after we kind of probably threw game three of last round. Very unfortunately. So I wonder what this deck could be. Okay. Buck. No idea what that is. Probably some kind of brew. I think the best play is to just attack. He blocks, we can Rampager, and if not, we just play a Tarmogoyf. Okay, he blocks. I like that. Getting rid of a Tarmogoyf like that's definitely helpful. Especially since we can still play two creatures next turn and have a 3/3. Second command comes in handy for sure. So if we draw a land, we might even be able to like roll him out of the waters next turn. We'll see. He looks like he's just on some kind of like mid-rangey good stuff buck deck. Probably Jace, Tarmogoyf, some DKs, Liliana, some discard. Mets from Pulse, stuff like that. Maybe it's like even that bug control deck is like an updated version of what Papiano has been running for a while. Who knows? We can at least kill Jace next turn, which helps. Do we even want to kill Jace though? 4, 5, 11, close to 4. I think it's probably better to kill Jace still, because of the pulse. Yep. Damage to Jace, damage to Jace. And 5 to the face. The other thing, otherwise, flashback pulse might just do too much. But not sure, maybe it would have been better to go face. I just felt like with the all in line there and the command not killing him since he would go to 4, there's like too many things that can go wrong. Like a discard spell on the command, some life gain, which would kind of put us into a bad spot. That's why I kept the land in hand, so in case he plays Liliana and wants to plus. But he's obviously gonna minus, which is really bad. Kalitas is probably gonna run away with the game here. Gonna deal damage to the face and hope to draw like a Rampager or something to win the game. That's not gonna do it. Gonna attack Liliana. But Kalidas is probably gonna lock out that game. That's pretty good. Like I already pointed out in my modern review, the card has quite the potential. It's just a bit, like, the format is just a bit hostile to her, I think, since the card doesn't look particularly impressive facing down Eldrazi monsters. But aside from Eldrazi, the card looks like a very good, very flexible card that can stabilize a game and pull you far ahead. This might actually be lethal if he doesn't have anything. But the question is, do I want to try go for it? Since he kind of should have something here. So if I attack, he goes to 7. If he tries to kill me, I kill that and put him to 4, then I'm 1 off and on 1. So I could draw one of the 3 Goyfs, 2 Rampagers, 4 Goblin Guides, the Bushwhackers. Would have a lot of outs. Is it more likely than trying to kill him? So what is going on right now? I feel like it is probably better than trying to command pump here into his open mana with 4 hand cards. I mean, he must have something. Yeah, I think I'm gonna try it like that. There's DK most likely. Okay, no DK. But regeneration either way. That kind of puts our plan off though. There's the DK. Okay, not much I can do. So we're basically just dead. So, pass is really good here, and I think that's about it. And Rampager is still probably good. Summons should be good because I don't expect him to have... counter magic. So I kind of think I'm just gonna like skimp on some bolts. Yeah, bolt doesn't seem that great. Since there's probably not much we can bolt aside from his face. That's a really good hand. An easy keep. Only this was a pass to exile and not the one bolt that we bought added we left in. But it's still fine, we can like bushwhack on turn 3 if we draw land. Either with the bolt or with the curtip, depending. And have a really powerful 1-2 punch. Straight to the face, 0 ambitions is definitely something that we like here. There's the third land for the Bushwhacker move if he has not discard. And it also helps through like a Tarmogoyf. Tarmogoyf being 3-2 next 2-3 next turn, so it doesn't even kill anything except the Bushwhacker. Oh no, we have to make it 4-3. That's a bit unfortunate. Hmm. 3-4 is really annoying. Question is, do I want to bolt the Goyf? So if I bolt the face, it goes to 11. Then Bushwhacker, he blocks Hurt Ape, he takes 7-9, so he goes to 2. That seems pretty decent. And if I bolt the face, he can still trade. Yeah, that's not a good option. To bolt the Goyf. So we just put him to 2 here. Like, putting him almost dead one turn earlier with so many minions in play, creatures in play. Played too much Hearthstone lately. So many creatures in play. Is better, I think, than like last turn where he had like more options in play and he had more mana already and we had less pressure in play. But now he basically has to deal with all but one creature that he can block. So he has to like kill 2 creatures and or gain some life or whatever, and we can draw a bunch of hasters and direct damage or a removal for Goyf if we have one creature left in play. So there's a lot of recourse that we have, even if he manages to like deal with what he has to deal with, which is not even that likely that he can. So if that's all he does, he's basically just dead. He will just go to 0. I think I like this stuff the way it is. I'll just keep it at that. A bit land heavy, but other than that, pretty good, I would say. I guess we kind of have to keep it. Yeah, probably have to keep it. A bit action light for that matchup. But since we have a pretty good opening that can also improve a lot. I normally don't like to keep hands that have more than 3 lands. Because this is basically like an okay 6 card hand. And already the third land. We have like, it's like 5.5 card hand. So like the average 6 card hand with a scry should be still better. It's an interesting choice. I think I'm mulligan because the hand also does like have no. Looks really bad against an early Tarmogoyf. That is better, I think. That's like the type of hand that I meant, basically. This is not good. But not much we can do. Mm-hmm. Kill the Liliana. I think if I'm not mistaken, he mulliganed as well. Yeah, he mulliganed as well. So that definitely helps. Guess we just attack with a Curt Ape. Devastating summons might help if he has no There's no pulse fight. Bell. Try that again. Bushwhacker, please. That's not what I had in mind. So the question is, do I summon here? I think I have to. Because otherwise Kalidas is gonna run us over. And the experiment ones become like reasonably sized. This is pretty bad. This is the matchup where you really want to draw a Pastor Exile or a Rampager early enough. But we didn't manage to. Yep, that's it. Okay. And that's it. See you for the last round. Losing that second round because of that misstep with the Reverie really is costing us here, running into such a deck that's not likely to face, but pretty good against what we are doing if he has Goyf and Kalidas all the time and we have no answer for them.